Hi! In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a simple and secure login system for a game that works on all platforms. I am Johannes, and this is Learn with Loot Locker. If your game intends to embrace cross-platform, you'll almost certainly want to let players create personal accounts so they can log in as themselves. That's true whether your take on cross-platform involves online multiplayer, interactions between players, or even online leaderboards. Allowing a player to pick a username and password essentially lets users log into your game as if it were a platform, regardless of what device they are playing on. Authentication of this kind keeps things simple and straightforward, both for you and for your players. It's tremendously powerful. In a cross-platform context, whether you're matchmaking, letting players create and trade items, or building a community, supporting personal account signups can also prove helpful in terms of engaging and retaining your players. The simple act of creating an account can create a connection with your players, particularly if there are bonuses or rewards for signup. Done right, this kind of authentication can make your users feel special, extending retention. That makes it a great tool for community building, and can also help with your efforts to form a connection with players and keep them updated with the likes of game news and offers. To follow along in this tutorial, you need to have a Loot Locker account created, a game to work on, and the Loot Locker SDK installed in your project. If you don't have that set up yet, you can find links in the description showing how to do that. Alright, let's get started. First, we need to configure some settings on how our login should work. So we head into the Loot Locker dashboard, click Settings, Platforms, and then White Label Login. Here we say what our company name should be when the user gets an email from us. The sender name is who the email is from. You can, if you want, just write something like info or account information in here. And then we have the Enable Account Verification slider, which I'll leave off for this example. But enabling this will send your users account verification requests when creating their accounts. And if you want to, you can make it so that they must verify their accounts first before being able to log into your game. And then we have our logo that will be included in the email. I've added our mascot Hector here. Then we have something called session length. This is for how long a user will be remembered on the server. We will look into this a bit more in the implementation, but essentially what this does is that it enables auto-login for your players. Great, all settings fixed. Make sure to click save to not lose any changes you've made before continuing. Here is the implementation that we're gonna use in this video. I'm going to give you a brief overview on how everything is structured here, and then we'll look at how it works. We have several buttons, and clicking on these buttons will call different functions in a script called White Label Manager. We first have these start buttons, which will show either the account creation page, the login page, or the reset password page. On the different pages here, we will call different functions. We call login on the login page, we call new user on the account creation page, and we will call the function reset password on the reset password page. When the button is clicked, an animation will start to play and will finish as soon as we've gotten a reply from the server. It will turn red and display error if we got an error, and it will say done if it were successful. Alright, let's take a look at the code that makes this possible. Here we have the White Label Manager, which is the script that calls the different functions. At the top here, we have a using statement for Loot Locker requests, which we need to make contact with the server. Then we have the input fields that we use when we send information to the server. One for a new user email, new user password, and a new user nickname. And then we also have for the existing user email, the existing user password, and also a reference to the animator on the login canvas. And also one for the reset password input field. Here we also have the variables for the toggle button that stores if the user wants to log in automatically or not. Then we have the buttons that we set animation triggers on when we get responses from the server here. And finally, we have a text component and an animator to show the player's nickname when they have logged in successfully. Now we'll look at what happens when we log in a player. White Label works a bit differently than something like a guest session. Guest sessions start a game session automatically, but with White Label you need to log in the player first. And when the player has been successfully logged in, then we will start a game session. First, we get the email and password that the player has put into the two input fields. And then we tell LootLocker that we want to log in the player by running lootlockersdkmanager.whitelabellogin. And in here, we pass in the email and password. Here we send the remember me boolean. This is what the session length on the LootLocker dashboard was. When this is enabled, the session will be remembered by LootLocker, so the player can log in automatically without needing to provide their email and password every time. We will look at the auto-login implementation a bit further down. If we get an error from LootLocker, we will trigger the error animation on our button, and then return. If it were successful, we will output to the log, and then continue. Then we have something called response.verifiedAt. This is what you would use if you want your players to verify their email before they can access your game. So just making sure that this isn't null is enough to implement that behavior. But as you can see in this implementation, I'm not doing anything specific here. Since the player now is successfully logged in, we can start a white label session with lootlockersdkmanager.startwhitelabelsession. This is what LootLocker needs to make game requests. Without this, the player would just be logged in but could not interact with the server in any way. If starting the session was not successful, we play the error animation and output it to the log. And if it were successful, we play the logged in animation and take the player's name and write it to the screen using this function, which gets the current player's name from the server and writes it to a text field in the scene. Now we'll look at what happens when we create a new user. First, we save the email, password and nickname that the user input in the text boxes. We then have a local function to handle any errors that we get. This is entirely optional, but it can be quite handy when you do multiple calls in a sequence to not repeat code unless needed. We then call LootLocker and say that we want to create a new account by executing white label signup. In this example, I made it so that the user's nickname is set when they create a new account. That is not needed if you don't want to. You could ignore that the player has no name and set it later or not at all if you prefer. If you don't want to set the player's nickname when creating the account, you simply just don't need to do anything more after you've got a successful response from the server here. However, it's usually a good idea to give your players a way to express themselves by choosing a nickname from the start, rather than needing to do it when they've already started the game. So I'll show you here how that can be done when creating the account. After we have created the account, to change the name of the player, we must have a valid session first. So we first need to log in the player by executing whitelabellogin and providing the email and password. When we get errors, we will run the local function and return so that the player can try again if there was an error. After the player has logged in, we will start a session so that we can make a call to the server. So we create a new session using startWhitelabelSession. After the player has logged in, if the player didn't provide a nickname, we will set it to be their public UID instead. Here you could use your own randomizer if you want, and give your players other names if you wanted to. Then we run setPlayerName to set the name to the new player. When we get a successful response from this call, we will end this session, since we don't want this session to be saved, since the player wasn't the one that started it. And when this is done, we set the RememberMe option to false, so that if a new user is created, they will be able to access the login page without the auto-login. Now we'll look at the auto-login functionality. First in start, which is called when the player starts the game, we check player prefs if the remember me option has been set. We then set the value of our toggle component in Unity to reflect this. Then we have the toggle remember me function. This is called when the value on the toggle is changed, so that means that after we check this in the start function, this function will execute to reflect the changes. We convert the boolean to an int here. This is just so that we can save it in player prefs. Depending on what state the toggle component changed to, we play either the on animation or the off animation. And then we save that to player prefs, so that it's remembered the next time the player starts the game. Now we have the auto-login function, which will be called if RememberMe is set to true. This is called on the first login button that the player presses. With the RememberMe option set, we first show and hide the different buttons that we will use. We will also start to play the spin animation on the login button. A session should already exist, so we don't need to set any login information to the server. That's what we use the check white label session for. If we get an error from this call, it means that there wasn't a valid session that could be used. This can happen if the player, for example, has RememberMe enabled but has been away for 30 days or more from your game. In that case, we will set the RememberMe toggle to false, which will make it so that the player will get to the login screen the next time they press this button. If it was successful, we will start a white label session and show the name of the current player on our game screen as with the login function. And if there was an error, we play the error animation and set the Remember Me toggle to false so that the player can try to log in again. If we don't have Remember Me enabled, we want to continue as usual. So I'm executing a function here which enables all the buttons inside of the login canvas. Then we have the password reset function. We should send a link to the assigned email address to reset the password. Your players just need to provide an email address and the password reset will be sent to that user's email address. And last but not least, we have the resend verification email function. I've not included this in the example since I'm not using the verification email in this example, but if you require your users to verify their email address before they can access your game, make sure that there is a way for them to resend the verification email in case it ends up in their spam folder or similar. And that's it for this video. White Label is a great and secure way to better connect with your players. And since White Label is completely cross-platforms, your players are now able to play your game and continue their progress on any platform that your game is available on. The full source code and Unity project that I've used in this example is available in the video description below. If you have any questions, just want to chat with us, or want to show off your game, you should join our Discord. Link is in the description. If you enjoyed this video, please leave a like, and to not miss out on any new content, make sure to subscribe. Alright, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.